Hi guys, this is Akira from EnglishWise, and today we are going to do the reading class for PTE. So in PTE exam, reading is the second part of the test, and there are five types of questions that will be covered in your reading exam of PTE. Now those five types of questions are, it starts with multiple choice questions, multiple answer, multiple choice questions, single answer, reorder paragraphs, drop down fill in the blanks, and drag draw fill in the blanks. Now there are these five types of questions, but the sequence of these questions in the exams keep changing. Like for example, if you go to the exam, you might get the sequence where your test will start with multiple choice question, multiple answer, then multiple choice question, single answer, then reorder paragraphs, then drag draw fill in the blanks, and then drop down fill in the blanks. This is one of the most common sequence that people get in the exam, but there are some other sequences as well. The second most common one is when the sequence starts in the reverse. So the test will start with drag draw fill in the blanks, then drop down fill in the blanks, or either which way, and then reorder paragraphs, and then both types of multiple choice. They can give you mixed and match as well, where it can start with multiple choice or fill in the blanks and then reorder, then multiple choice or fill in the blanks again. So the sequence keeps changing for each individual person. There is no specific sequence that everybody is supposed to get, or a specific sequence that you will always get in the exam. So you can get any kinds of sequence. So we will discuss each type of question individually. One by one we will go on to the details of the question. Before we go further into detail of each individual type of questions, I just want to discuss how many questions you will be expecting in the exam, so that you are mentally prepared for that many questions of that type of question. So for multiple choice, multiple answer, you'll be getting 2 to 3 questions. For multiple choice, single answer as well, you'll be getting 2 to 3 questions. For reorder paragraphs as well, same 2 to 3 questions. For drag and drop fill in the blanks, you can get either 4 or 5 questions. And the last one, for drop down fill in the blanks, you can get 5 to 6 questions as well. So the maximum number of questions you'll be getting in drop down fill in the blanks. The time that you get for the test is 32 to 41 minutes, but on average people usually get around 35 to 38 minutes, but it could be any time depending upon the number of questions that you're getting in each. Now, the scoring in PTE is a little complicated because the reading score is calculated not just from reading section of the test, but from other sections of the test as well. So actually your reading score that is calculated, the reading score that you see on your PTE report card, is not coming from these five questions only. It's coming from some questions in speaking, listening and writing as well. So I'll tell you which questions those are. So in speaking part of the test, read aloud is one of those questions that gives you a lot of reading score. Then in listening part of the test, there are two questions actually: highlight incorrect words and highlight correct summary. And in writing part of the test, the first question that you encountered in writing part of the test, summarize written text, that question also gives you reading score. Now before we go into the detail of each type of question, there is something very important. The very reason why people miss points in the exam, the very problem that everybody faces in the reading part of the test, that is timing. Timing is one of the biggest problems that everybody faces in the reading part of the test. So in this lecture, we will not only cover all the questions individually, but we will also devise a strategy to how to manage time in your exam. Now, since there are five types of questions, what we can do is we can figure out which type of question is important and which type of question is not important. By important, I mean that the one that is giving you maximum points. What happens in the test is usually when you get your test starts with multiple choice, the single answer or multiple answer, then multiple choice, multiple answer, then reorder, then drag, drop and drop down. What happens because of the timing problem is that by the time people reach drag, drop, or by the time people just finish drag, drop, they notice that time is running out. They notice that only 2-3 minutes are left now. Then two things happen. Either those people take the decision to just guess all the answers in drop down fill in the blanks just to cover each question, or some other people, they just start solving everything, and again in that as well they miss. So if you guess as well, there is a very less chance that all the guesses will work, and if you miss other questions as well, again there is no chance that you will get points for that. So what happens is, because of that, our reading score goes down. Another important thing here is that the last question that we usually miss the drop down fill in the blanks, that gives 20 to 25 points in reading and 20 to 25 points in writing. Because of missing that question, you don't only lose reading score, but you lose writing score as well. So there is no point, we cannot afford to miss that question. We need to reach that question in time. And since that is one of the questions that takes maximum time to solve as well. So we not only need to reach it, but we need to have enough time to solve that as well. So the strategy that I'm going to tell you to manage your timing is based on the same thing. How to reach the drop down fill in the blanks in time and how to have enough time to solve this. Since I am telling you that the drag drop and drop down fill in the blanks are the most important questions as they give maximum points, on the other hand, multiple choice questions are not at all important because they don't give you enough points. And usually why we miss these fill in the blanks is because of multiple choice questions already. Now multiple choice questions take a lot of time to solve and they leave you frustrated as well. And even after spending a lot of time on multiple choice questions, we are never ever sure of our answer. So what strategy we are going to follow is that we will take away some time from multiple choice questions and we will put that time into fill in the blanks. We will put that time into some question that is more promising for us, that is giving us more points. The one that I did not discuss in timing is a reorder paragraphs. Now reorder paragraphs is important, but it's not as important as fill in the blanks. And it again, reorder paragraphs is also that kind of question that takes a lot of time. So we need to limit the time for reorder paragraphs as well. So on reorder paragraphs, we will spend minimum 2 and maximum 2.5 minutes on each question. So if you're getting 2 reorder paragraphs in your exam, you will spend 4 to 5 minutes. If you're getting 3 reorder paragraphs in your exam, then you will spend 6 to 7.5 minutes on that. So again, I'll just go over the timing again before we move forward. So on multiple choice, multiple answer question, and on multiple choice single answer question, we are not spending any time. We are spending actually 0 seconds on it because we are not solving it because it is not worth it. On reorder paragraphs, we are spending 2 to 2.5 minutes on each question, and on fill in the blanks, we are spending the remaining time. Now, there is no specific amount of time that can be suggested that you should spend on fill in the blanks, but I can guide you with that try not to spend more than 3 minutes on each fill in the blank, because fill in the blanks are like that, like drag and drop take a little bit lesser time, drop and down take a little bit more time, and sometimes one blank is very easy, the paragraph is very easy, you are able to solve it in 1 minute, but the other one might be a little bit difficult, so you're gonna have to do it in 3 minutes. So there is no specific limit of time that I will suggest for you to spend on fill in the blanks, but yes, I will suggest that please try not to spend more than 3 minutes on each fill in the blank, otherwise you will run out of time very soon. Now, after discussing this, let's move on to discussing each question one by one. We will start with the very first section, that is multiple choice questions. Now the first section, multiple choice questions, let's revise a little bit of facts again. So you're supposed to get 2 to 3 questions in multiple choice single answer question. We will be discussing multiple choice single answer question first of all. So you will get 2 to 3 questions. This question, actually the strategy is very simple how to solve it. So you will be given some text, and on the basis of that text, there will be a question given. Under that question, there will be some options given for your reference. What you are supposed to do is you are supposed to read that question. You are supposed to find the answer to that question from the text given. And whichever option matches your answer, you are just supposed to click on that option and press the next button. Guys, there is no previous button in the test. There is only next button. So once you solve a question, you can never come back to it. So you just have to select the correct option and you press the next button. That is what you have to do. But since we are spending only 0 seconds on multiple choice questions again, so we don't have any time to solve it. So what are we going to do then if we are not going to solve it? We are going to guess the answer. That is what we can do in 0 seconds. So we will guess our answer with option number C. Now if I'm telling you to guess, you can go with any wild guess. You can go with any option or any number that you prefer. But I suggest option number C because in PTE exam, option number C has the most probability of being correct. If it's your lucky day, all the C's that you click on will be correct. If it's a very, very unlucky day, then we can save out it. But if it's your lucky day, then all the C's can be correct. So the hack is that you just have to click on option number C and press the next button. Now, there is no negative marking in this question. If I talk to you about scoring, there is 1 point for the correct answer, 0 points for the wrong answer. Since there is no negative marking, again, if your C is correct option, then you will get 1 point. If C is wrong, then you will get zero. But it's a healthy risk. You are not losing anything out of it. There is no negative marking, so you will not get minus one. You will only get zero. So that is all about multiple choice, choose single answer question. Now let's move to multiple choice, choose multiple answer question. Now this is another type of multiple choice question that you get in your exam. Again, the number of questions will be same. You are supposed to get 2 to 3 of multiple choice, multiple answer questions in your exam. Again, the strategy is the same, the question type is also the same. The only difference is that the text is a little bit longer in this question. So the text you get in multiple choice single answer is little bit smaller in size, but the text you get in multiple choice multiple answer is little bit longer in size. And with respect to that, again, the question is a little bit longer and options are longer as well. And not only this, the options are more as well. Usually on average in multiple choice single answer question you get 4 options as we discussed in the last question, but in multiple choice multiple answer question you can get more than 4 options as well. It might be 5, 6 or even 7 options. So basic strategy is same as again, that you have to read the question and you have to find the answer to that question in the text given to you. Now more than one options will match with the answers, so you have to click on more than one options and then press the next button. Again, if we discuss the scoring, now this one has negative marking, so you have to be very careful about this. So if you click on the correct answer, you will get +1 for that correct option. But if that option was wrong, then you will get -1 for that. So +1 for the correct one, -1 for the wrong one, and the minimum score that you can get is 0. Now again, if we go back to our timing strategy, we decided that we will spend 0 seconds on multiple choice, multiple answer questions as well. So if we are spending 0 seconds again, we don't have any time to solve it. So what are we going to do? We are going to guess the answer. But again, we are not going to guess with more than one options. Yes, I know that this question is multiple choice, multiple answer, but we cannot guess with more than one options. Let's take an example here. If I select C and D, let's say I select 2 options to be correct, C and D. If C is correct, I will get +1 for that. But if D is wrong, I will get -1 for that. So +1, -1, eventually I will end up with 0. So that is why I will only guess with one option, that is option number C. Guys, there is a very good chance that one option will be correct that you guess. But two of the guesses being correct, that's a very, very rare chance. So please don't take that risk. Select only one option. If that option is correct, we will get +1 point. If that option is wrong, we will get 0. But if you're selecting 2 or 3 options, there's a very, very, very high chance that eventually you will get 0. So we will guess with one option, that option that has the most probability of being correct, that is option number C.